Hey guys, welcome back to the shop. It's Go Fast with Class, and I don't think I ever did a full video on this. I've got a lot of footage that I'll throw in here, but long and short is I bought a Bridgeport, and I'm pretty excited about that. So it is a variable speed head. It came from a local military subcontractor. It's got a little Mitutoyo DRO with it. Kind of adjust my light so you guys can see that. The ways look really good all the way around, even underneath the table. I got this, I think it's actually a Kurt Weiss, although the logo's worn off of the side, and I haven't taken it off, but it looks like an older Kurt Weiss, but it came with it. I've got power only on one axis. Everything works on it. It works actually reasonably or extremely well. It's a pretty reasonably tight machine, especially for a guy in his home shop, which is pretty awesome. I am super happy about it, and I've been making chips. Little look at the lead screw here. For the most part, it looks really good. It's covered in a lot of crud right there. It's clean in the middle, and then it's covered with crud over here. And this is just completely gummed up right here. So that's completely disgusting. It wasn't loose, but it would get tight on the ends, and now I know why, because the parts where it would get tight is the part where it's gummed up. So here it would literally just stop because it was gummed up over here, and it got real tight in this area. The underside of the table looks pretty good. The problem though is my one-shot oiler system is working in some places, but not working at all in others. So I've got to unclog that. The underside actually looks pretty good. I don't know if you can see that. Don't think you can. But anyway, the underside still has a good amount of flake on it. So that's pretty cool. Maybe you can get a little bit of a better angle on this side here. I've got it cleaned up. It's a whole lot better than it was. Not perfect, but I'm not going for perfect. I'm going for clean and usable. I will work on perfect later, but I got most of this gack out of here. This was so gummed up, you couldn't actually turn it past somewhere in here. You can actually see that it's metal now instead of gunk colored. So that's pretty nice. And the same thing on this end. This was all full of gunk. I've got some stuff that I made for a friend of mine, some hydraulic tank things that I will throw in some images of that. Machine the other end off, put this groove in it. I cut this hole here and then machine the groove in this. And so but I am real excited about this guy. Like I said, it works extremely well. It does everything I need. The only thing I really have that's an issue is of my own doing. I just don't have that much tooling. The lack of tooling and the learning curve is really the only thing that's a problem on this machine. But other than that, I mean, it's in fantastic shape in all the places that matter. Thanks for watching. Hope you enjoy. If you like what you see, give me a like, give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you want to see more. I've got more videos coming up with the 50 truck and all the other random stuff I'm working on. See you guys soon.